killing me. Get off my feet. Guys are crazy nowadays. Like, it's chaos. They tickle my feet and they surround me and then they rush for their food. You guys saw. But at least by having two pipes, I can get most of them started on this one while I clean up and take care of this area and put in their food into the other pipe. So it works out okay. So it is the start of week 5 and we're heading into week 6. And right now we have one bag of chicken food and whatever's in the buckets left, and the store still hasn't gotten our order in. We ordered 200 kilograms of food because that's probably what we're going to need, and it's still not in, so we're a little bit worried. Oh God. I think they still prefer to drink from the small waterer, but most of them have already worked out the big one, which is great. Because the big one's just going to make it a lot easier for us to maintain, to keep clean, and to have filled up, while this one really runs out quickly. This little storage box has turned out to be a great chicken equipment storer, right next to the brooder, keeping it nice and clean. Try find a little one. Okay, there you go. This is probably, hold on, let me pick you up properly. There you go. This is probably one of the smaller ones. Okay. And this might actually, oh my God, be one of the bigger ones. Hold on. You're fine, come here. Wow, such a big difference between some of them. This is all the food we have left. Our stock feed still hasn't got feed in, and it's been several weeks. I mean, we got all this chick food while they were all still very young. We got 7 bags worth, everything they had, and ordered 200 kilograms, and it still hasn't come in. So I'm worried.
The rain makes it so hard. Okay, guys.
everyone.
It's the end of week 6. It's actually officially week 7. And I have been working all week, so we actually haven't seen these guys since the start of the week. And let me tell you that this week, these guys have grown sideways. Have a look at how big their bellies have gotten.
So many chickens.
Can I pick you up? Huge. There you go. Who are you pecking me for? Excuse me. I'm not a flower. All right, let's get you guys cleaned up. It has been raining all week, so it's looking pretty mucky in here. The grass where they have been though, it's actually starting to grow back and it's looking really good. You can see everywhere they've been, and it gets worse and worse, of course, because they were here last. But not bad. Not Ferris. While these guys are busy, I can fill up the other pipe for them and put it under the shelter. But we actually ended up running out of chicken food this week. We are down to our last bag. You saw me use it as I came over. And even though we ordered chicken food through our co-op like a month ago, if not more, it still hasn't arrived. And is not due to arrive till like next week. And that's not the fault of the company that makes the food. So today the plan is actually not only just to go hunting around the whole area looking for bags of chick feed that are actually organic, made by Country Heritage, which is what we've been feeding these guys the whole time, and we really don't want to have to make a switch to something unnatural for the last few weeks. But today we're also getting some of our native trees and plants to put into our native edible food forest, full of Australian plants that you can eat and cook with and use as spices. I'm so excited. I'm so excited that we have worked together, guys. We've gotten to 500 subscribers and this is going to be our next huge project here on the property. So super excited to take you along for that. I have to get to work though. I still have 2 hours of work this morning and then I'll be coming home to do lots and lots of things for these guys. Lots and lots of things for the property.
Nice and peaceful now. The garden is looking fantastic at the moment and I do have a tour coming out really soon. I think it's the next video.
Yeah, the rains have really been beneficial for it. It's really taking off, including all of the weeds in the pathways. So we need more wood chips.
Stop rounding them up. Come on, let's go home.
I think Eris got zapped by the fence one too many times. He's not so keen to come up here.
Sheep. Keen. Hi, sheep. Careful. Sheep. Hi. Sheep. Oh, no. That is such a scaredy cat. Hey. Morning. Hi. Well, oh, no, your shelter fell down again. I'm sorry.
I think this might end up being another project for today or in the next few days. Don't tell Sam, but that's part of living on the homestead, is you have jobs to do, you're already flat out getting them all done, and then things pop out of nowhere, like having to make sure there's shelters for animals that are working, having to make sure there's enough water. So your day turns out busier than it intends to be.
Hi, sheep sheep.
Hi.
Hello. I appreciated that. Thank you.
The sheep are actually comfortable enough with us now that while they've got their pellets and they're munching away, and even without them, they're approaching us. But what's really amazing is they're comfortable enough that while they're eating, I can come up and have a really good look at them. I can pull their eyes down at this point to check them to make sure they're healthy and they don't have any worms in their gut. So they're patient enough for that. I can give them scratches all over. And our ewe, Alf, she even lets me check her teats and lift her tail up, which, being a mother, is going to be really important for me keeping track of her health and make sure that she's going along well in her pregnancies. So I'm still not certain if she's pregnant or not. She was walking around with the ram for a long time, but maybe she was too young or it just didn't work out for them. Still keeping an eye on her, and once 4 months passes since the day that we got them, if there's no little lamb, then we'll just assume it didn't work out this time round. This energizer has been amazing. Their paddocks have been amazing. It's all been really easy and streamlined.
This garden's doing really well as well. See, my zucchinis are coming up, and also a little cucumber. Not sure if that one's gonna make it so far. My cucumbers haven't been making it.
The next lot of little carrots have started to come up as well. And when there's weeds, we just give them a little pull. Beans have started to climb. Check it out. The onions are looking incredible. I reckon they'll be ready to come out soon. I'm just sad I didn't plant nearly enough. Flowers and herbs. It looks like we've got dill that has come up. That looks like a volunteer tomato. We might stake her up if she wants to live there. I'm gonna let her. Not sure what this plant is, but it's got plenty of little flowers. I actually remember playing with these when I was little. Well, I remember playing with these when I was little and like cooking with them and pretending they were like pumpkins or something. Oh, that onion. Oh, she's a big boy. I could spend hours in my garden, but I really need to go get ready for work. So I'm gonna have to catch you guys up when I come back this afternoon. These need to be harvested, like all the leaves are dead now. Yes, come.
Oh. Quick, 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 quick. We're gonna miss it.
Eris.
Oh. Stay, stay, come here, come here.
Oh my God, you are going too close to that. I think our bees are swarming. So our hive is finally, our hive is splitting. Look at them all. Not sure if you can see. Wow, it's so loud. Somewhere up there, the queen has just taken off. They are pouring out. Conditions are perfect.
It's so calm.
It's a little bit precarious being that close to them, but wow. Wow, there are so many bees in the air.
So this is really exciting, guys. We were expecting this. It means that the hive that we, the swarm that we captured was so large that when they got in our box and we had to upgrade them to another level, they were so abundant and so ready, they're splitting. So we've enabled them to essentially multiply. So these guys are gonna take off and go find another place to swarm and try and find another hive. And we are going to be able to keep the other half and we'll have a much more reasonably sized, whoa, they're coming this way. Oh, they're coming straight past me.
Hey.
And then we're gonna end up with a much more reasonably sized bee box. After they've already made us tons of honey. You can smell it all around the house, it's amazing.
Oh, Di's...
Di's due home any moment. If she catches this, she'll be so excited. Oh, kind of feel like I'm just in the middle of it right now.
They seem to be congregating down there,
right where the our fruit trees are growing. So there must be a queen over there. So there's still bees coming and going out of the hive, but between here and where the trees are, there's just nothing but bees. They're just flying everywhere. I was not expecting to spend today looking at this. The poor dog has no idea what's going on. Eris, what's wrong, mate? Too much buzzing, it's a bit loud around here, is it? It's all right, mate. We're gonna sit here and we're gonna enjoy this. Wow. They're
actually congregating on the grass over there. Just where you can see the container, on the grass right there, there's just a huge buildup.
Let's go back around. Yeah, they're swarming on our tree. They're swarming right here. Oh man, if only we had a box.
So it looks like the swarm is completely congregated right here. There are still bees coming and going from the box. Let's go have a quick look at it. Stay low, because...
Yeah, look. Oh, see these guys are doing their own thing. They are kind of coming and going from the swarm. But there are still bees coming and going from in here.
I'm not seeing any honey or nectar attached to them or anything, so these guys must be the ones that are staying.
Today just got really interesting.